Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss second topic, information life cycle. This is the second topic. In this we have generation, collection, storage and dissemination. Let us see. So information life cycle, what it is? It is the process by which knowledge is created, produced, disseminated, organized, diffused, utilized, preserved and destroyed. Here we have the information life cycle. So you create, collect, then organize, store, access, deliver and use. Let us first we'll know about the generation. So how information is generated? It is generated by different human activities and events, and may be done by an individual or by the government organizations, and things that may happen or took place. So we have the activities, that is the information is generated by few activities like survey, research activities and other activities. Let us have a diagrammatic representation. So the activities, this is a diagrammatic representation. We can say tools of information generation, that is surveys and census, then research and development, then activities of government or other activities. So what are these census and verses? So the information life cycle, we have surveys, census, research and development. So surveys and census means they are an auxiliary research activities, and these gather statistical information. That is, in India, the Office of the Chief Register General conducts census at every 10 years intervals to collect population data. Usually the popularly what we know is only the survey, but there is also census where this chief registrate general will conduct for every 10 years. And these from the basis of demographic studies of the country, such as birth rate, death rate, sex ratio, literacy rate, etc. This is done by the government. So let us find out the difference between these two. What are the census versus survey? Census means collect information about every member of the population, whereas survey, it is only from the sample of population. So census is more detailed and accurate data, because it is done by the government, the data should be accurate. And whereas survey is accurate or reliable as a census, it may be or may not be. And the census take a long time to complete, because they want exact information they will collect, not just 100 people we go and we survey and in short period we'll complete the things. It's not like that. Census, it takes a long time to complete, whereas survey can be done in short period of time compared to the census. And the census is generally conducted by the government, I said you before, and this is conducted by any survey can be done anywhere regarding anything. And here census are not conducted frequently, it is only for every 10 years they will be conducting these census, whereas survey can be conducted frequently regarding any issue or regarding anything. So census means we said the government is going to take it. Then what are those things? It is nothing but the policy departments give information about dowry, death, corruption, accident, etc. And state planning commission of the government generate an enormous amount of information on almost all dimensions. These two are the activities of the government with respect to the census. Okay, then information is collected. Then what that information we need to do? So it has to be stored in some form, right? So it can be stored in print form or non-print form. Then from where all we can collect the information? So collection and storage of information may be from libraries or documentation centers or information centers. Then we disseminate the information, dissemination of information services. So let us find out what is this documentation center and what type of information we collect from these centers. So here we have the documentation centers. So what it refers to? It refers to the organizing, it refers to the act of reading information. And this documentation center collects a wide range of material from governmental or inert governmental and local and international non-governmental sources. And this developed with the increasing research, usually by research. After doing the research, this documentation center will collect the information and store it in scientific periodical gained importance. So new set of techniques like indexing, abstracting, union catalog, etc. are developed using this documentation centers. Okay, in addition, translation, microphotography, etc. are also adopted to meet the need of the specialist users. Efforts are started to collect information as microliterature. And these new activities are given a new name called documents. So overall, what we will understand is this information means documentation center. After doing a research, they'll collect the information and they will document it, which is used for the further use. So we understood about the documentation center. After doing the research, what all we do, just now I explained. So information centers means, again, some information is collected from those centers. And libraries. Libraries have all kind of information, whatever research, journals, articles, whatever information you want, you can collect from them. In the same manner, how these documentations, from the documentation center we are collecting the information, we can collect information from information center and the libraries. Then we can store in a proper way, then the dissemination of information will take place. Now let us know about this information center. So this information centers, this provides services like referral service, literature search, translations, biographies, abstracting, etc. to its users. And usually these information centers are designed for storing, processing, retrieving information and for dissemination at regular intervals. So what information we have, where it is referred, from where the information has come, everything we can found from the information centers. And same like libraries. Like libraries also we get information. All kind of data is stored in the library. So in this way, the data collected will be stored and later on it is disseminated. Like let us see once again the cycle. So here we go, information transfer cycle. Create, we collected from information center or documentation center or libraries or wherever surveys or census, we collect the information and we organize and will store in some other documentation centers in a print form or non-print form or micro form. Then it will be accessed, then disseminated or delivered to the user. This all about